I'm Ansley representing GILI Sports, and this video is for beginners who want to learn how to paddleboard. So today we're going to go over three basics, which include board handling, paddle handling, and of course, safety. Now before you get on the board, you need to start by sizing your paddle, and this is called the hands-up method. So you're going to place your paddle parallel to your body, and with your other arm, you're going to shoot it straight up and then adjust your paddle so that your hand can fit comfortably on the T-grip. When it does feel comfortable, just lock it in place.
Once you have your paddle size correctly, you're going to attach your leash to your ankle. This ensures that your board will stay nearby if you happen to fall off. When you go to pick your board up off the ground, you want to lift it up by the rail first and then grab the carry handle. Once you get in the water, walk in deep enough so that the fins behind you clear the sand. To mount the board, you're going to start by placing your knees on either side of the handle so you're centered on the board. You can take a few strokes on your knees to help get your balance before standing up. To get up, you're going to put your paddle down in front of you, put your feet where your knees were, and stand up. Keep your paddle in the water to help keep you stable. You don't want to get stuck in a squatting position where you're leaning forward or looking down because that makes it hard to balance on the board. Start paddling as soon as you stand up, as this will build momentum and help you stay more steady. Make sure to stand with your feet parallel and hip width apart. Keep your toes facing forward and your knees slightly bent. Don't paddle solely from your arms. Your core strength is where it's at. Keeping your head up high and looking straight out ahead will help you maintain balance on the board. Resist the urge to look down at your feet.
Now we are going to talk about paddle handling. An easy way to remember how to hold your paddle at the correct width is to put your arms above your head like this. You don't want to make the mistake of putting your hands too close together or too far apart.
You're going to hold the paddle with the blade angled away from you and pull it through the water. Many beginners hold the paddle backwards like this, but this doesn't allow you to get much power from your stroke. You don't want to make your stroke out here, too far away from your board, or it will cause you to start turning. The correct way is to keep your paddle straight up and down and keep it close to the board. Put it in the water and pull it from the nose to the tail in a straight line with your knees slightly bent. This is called a forward stroke. If you're stationary, keep your paddle in the water to help you balance. When you want to turn your board, one of the easiest ways to do this is with sweep strokes. For the forward sweep, you're going to place your paddle in the water at the nose and make a big, wide arc away from your board and back in towards the tail like this. It's a great way to turn your board if you're in motion or if you're stationary. The reverse sweep is just the same, but you'll start from the tail and make an arc towards the nose. It can also be used while stationary or while traveling forward.
When it comes to paddleboard safety, there are a few things to remember.
One of the most important ways to stay safe on the water is to wear your leash. This ensures that if you fall off, your board will never float too far from you and it will be easy to get back on. The only time you shouldn't wear your leash is when you are paddling in a river, as it can get tangled in debris or fallen trees, which can be hazardous. When you head out on the water, be sure to bring a personal flotation device, either a standard life vest like this or a waist pack flotation device. They can be the first line of safety in an emergency, so they're absolutely worth bringing. It's important to be aware of any hazards in the water and try to avoid them. This includes things like reefs, fallen trees, or shallow rocks. Before you get on the water, make sure you are using the correct fin for your environment. We've got the 3-inch river fin, the 4.5-inch speed fin, and the 8-inch dolphin fin. If you fall off your board, and it's bound to happen, try to fall away from your board so you don't land on it. Then get right back on. While treading water next to your board, grab onto the center handle and use it to pull yourself up. Pull on the handle with your arm and kick with your legs to get back on your board. When you're finished paddling, you want to make sure to dismount your board safely. Once you reach knee-deep water, kneel down on the board with your hands in front of you. Place one foot in the water and drag it on the bottom to stop the board. Then move off the board and stand up. If you're in a rocky area, you may want to put shoes on before dismounting. Overall, paddleboarding is a great, safe, and low-impact sport. It has several benefits, including improving balance and core strength, being great for mental and physical health, and also improving balance.
I hope after today's lesson, you have the confidence to get out on the water and have a fun and safe time on your paddleboard.